Hey, we're Team Liquid School, the team behind the action-adventure game Kuin. I'm Kira, I did the project management as well as the programming of the main character and some of the enemies.
My name is Vincenzo, I'm responsible for level design as well as programming of the enemies and the interactable objects.
Hi, my name is Linard, I'm a programmer and I created the underlying structure of our game and our shaders as well as building the tools for the level designers and the other programmers.
Hi, I'm Lena. I mainly did concepts and assets for the background, and I'm also responsible for the management and coordination of the art team.
Hi, my name is Mario. I'm an illustrator. I was responsible for character design, some creature designs, and I also helped with animations and some extra decoration for the levels.
Hi, I'm David. I helped out with the art for Corinne. I also did some level design and built up our social media.
Okay, then let's start right into the game. A passing by planet brings with it a dark power, causing horrible mutations to all life. A protection mechanism was brought long ago by visitors from a faraway place. To restore its power, however, one has to use mystical heads to make their way through the visitors' ancient buildings, riddled with traps and monsters. The headmaker of a village, hidden from the rest of the world, and keeper of ancient secrets, entrusts the traveler Kuin with this task and the tea drinker's head. Yeah, as we learned from the intro, we are going to be playing Kuin, which, by the way, is kind of an anxious person, overwhelmed by the task to having to save the world, and we have to pass through these ruins, which are full of obstacles, like these small mutated plants at the top of the room there. And we can easily move on when we hit them with our staff attack. Now we have another puzzle of the ruins coming up, this small pressure plate, which we can step on and then pass through the door. We can see here a pushable block, and you can probably imagine that the puzzles will get a lot harder later on. And we can use our dash ability to cross past this chasm and move on to the next room, where we are awaited by these small nightmarish creatures clinging to us and slowing us down. In a way, maybe like fear does, and maybe that's intentional, but we can easily shake them off by dashing or moving around a lot and then hit them with our staff attack to continue on.
After we defeated all the enemies, we come into the next room. We can already see a door down here and another pressure plate on the right, but unfortunately the pressure plate is too far away to reach the door in time, so we have to search for something else. But here at the top we have another plant and a glass tank which we can destroy to collect some items. These collectibles are hidden in our levels, so only the best player will find them all. Now to activate this pressure plate here, we have to use a hidden block here on the right, which can be pushed again on the pressure plate. Now we can proceed into the next room. Here we are locked up again, and the ranged enemy awaits us. He shoots some dangerous projectiles at us, and we have to be aware that we are not hit by them, because Kuin will build up a panic attack, and if we are hit again in this state, we'll be reset to an earlier stage in the level. Here we can use the tea head to shoot some burning hot tea projectiles at him, and we need to defeat him to be able to proceed. We can also use the objects in our level, like these broken tanks here, to seek some shelter. We can also see some round circles on the body of the enemy, which indicates with the blinking that the enemy is ready to attack. So we can watch out that we are not hit by the projectiles anymore. After we defeated all the enemies, we can proceed with the next room, which is another protection mechanism of the ruins. This is a puzzle where we have to use our heads to be able to proceed. The goal is here to find a valid path from the beginning to the exit of the puzzle, which is the lower right corner. Here we need to match the symbols on the ground, which are light up, so we are not able to walk on this ground symbol, but we need to walk over this triangle shape symbol to be able to build a valid path from the beginning to the exit. If we walk over the wrong tiles, we are reset back to the beginning of the puzzle.
Here in the next room we see another puzzle of the ruins, which is built up from these crystals, and we can hit them to make the lights at the top of the room light up. And our goal is to light all the lights up, and luckily we know the solution and can pretty quickly solve this puzzle and then move on. In the next room, we can either just dash to the exit, or we can collect the collectibles at the lower corner of the room. And as Vincenzo said, only the best can get them all, so we are going to move on. Here we have another enemy of the ruins, which is this close combat enemy, and we can either also engage in close combat with our staff, or we can try to shoot him from afar, but he's pretty quick. And it might be easier to hit him from close distance, but we made it and now we can go on.
Here we have another hallway, which seems to lead us up to something big. Then we come into a large room where multiple paths lead away from here. But now it's your turn to explore the ruins further.
To do so, you can go to our itch.io page, download the game and even give us some feedback. And if you want to get some further background information or updates about our development process, you can follow us on Twitter, Instagram and even Facebook.
Thanks for watching and see ya!